Dover Swingate. Hundreds and hundreds of bunkers. And we're coming to some more bunkers. So it looks like there's four. One looks like sort of good condition, the other one okay, and then they sort of go to rubble. But we don't know what these things are, so we're definitely gonna look. They might be magazines for a gun battery. So let's take a look at this. Right, these actually look like they got the original door still on them. This is gonna be quite a good little explore actually. Very windy as you can hear. But yeah, what are these bunkers? Must be some sort of ammo store or something like that. Generator buildings, I don't know. Let's take a look.
Really? Yeah. What are you got one of these on the way of
code? No, it's just
you know, what we got here?
I'm not getting my main torch out, I'll just use this. You can see in there, can't we, folks? Nothing, empty room. There must have been some sort of ammo store.
Yeah, but I certainly do love the original doors that we have here. The blocks have been chucked up against it to try and stop them from flying over. But this is one bunker, one out of four. So there we have, there's another one there. Yeah, so there's the second one. It's got bloody trees growing out of it. Jesus.
Nature's just taken over.
Yeah. That certainly does look unsafe. Look at that, folks. Jesus. Look at this. Blimey. The bricks have fallen off over the years. What can you see inside this one? Hands are actually cold.
Yes, but yeah, you can see a little bit actually. But it's basically just another room, folks.
So that was two out of... Oh, actually, it's five, six bunkers.
Yeah, but they're getting smaller and smaller.
They're getting smaller and smaller, folks, yeah. Don't know, it might be just been the top part that's just rubble. Might be a door still on it. We should check it out. Right, let's take a look inside this room. Obviously, because the ground's higher, we filled in inside a bit more. Can you see?
Yeah. You can see the whole thing.
Yeah, so God knows what these were. Lovely smooth wall zone. Oh, we've got a light fixture here.
There's some graffiti here. Is that the same 1960?
Yeah, it's old graffiti that. Shows a lot of...
B Bell, does that say? Or G Bell?
G maybe. Yeah, that's
1960.
Good. This is looks like a gun battery one. Looks like the one similar brickwork to Fan Bay and South Fulham Battery. But there's the light fixture there. Lovely. And it seems to go off, and these are the cable poles that go off. And there's another one here. That's probably a cable as well. Well, then this is a ventilation, surely. That'll be a ventilation one. Yeah, excellent.
46,
apparently.
Whoa! See, I didn't even see that.
Is there any others?
1946, folks. World War II graffiti.
D2.
Well, just over World War II, actually.
Does that say 54? What's that say to you, mate? Does that say 54 on that one?
Can't tell.
Moran, does that say? CPL? Corporal, is that? Does that say CPL? Gabriel J. Moran. What's that one?
1965, yeah, look.
And then 679 up there.
Lots of crosses. Come to the last two or last one bunker. It does look like a pile of rubble.
Till.
The top has been smashed away. But we can get down into there. I'll just take this I'll leave my bag there, mate.
Yep. All right.
I'm getting it. Okay. Right, we're in.
You alright?
Yeah. It's not making that look very easy.
No, I won't be going down there.
That's alright, it's just...
Oh. Definitely going to be looking after the graffiti anyway. So yeah, this is more to ground level. It's backfilled there.
Yeah, 100% backfilled.
Oh no. I've just realised something. Look at the spider's egg sack hanging down. Jesus. Spider's den. There's the, look at that, still got the lock in place there. Oh, that mud. Oh, right. Yeah, so the, no graffiti in this one, unfortunately. I'm a bit worried about the amount of mud behind this door. But yeah, it's worth going in to see. There might be something in here. Now I've got to struggle to get out. It's so wet here, that's the trouble.
Can you imagine me going into the Plimsolls?
That's what I love about exploring, getting your hands dirty. Yeah! Woo! Right, so we come out of that bunker. Bit of a muddy one. We've got the last one, which I really don't know what's going on with these bunkers because each one seems to be getting more underground. The first one we went up to, it was really exposed, the walls were anyway. So this last one, apparently can't get into it. Yes, and that's 100% true. The bunker's down there, but unfortunately, if we can dig it out, but there's no really no point because it's just a room down there. But obviously it could be graffiti from people from the Second World War or 1970s, say. So yeah, super day out. We're just having a check near the main road, see if there's any more bunkers. We're actually going to cross the road. This is quite a it's quite dangerous here, actually. We're underneath the Dover Steel Road, and the people above us now, you can hear, don't even know this tunnel's here. The location I'm at today is a commando hideout bunker. This would have been used in the event of invasion of the country. They're scattered along the country, around the country, and this would have been used as a hideout.
Put this tire up.
Yeah. Oh, look at this. I hate getting on and rolling about in mud.